Was touch and go with you for a while. Name's John Cinnamoy. I'm the head lifeguard here. Voice on the radio told me you were in trouble at the hotel. Said you were resistant to whatever this is. I didn't believe it. But then I found you and I saw the bite marks. You got no symptoms, but... those aren't love bites, are they? Look, I don't know who you are or how you know that guy on the radio. But he's our only connection with the outside world. We keep losing the bloody signal. We have a monsoon coming. So here's the thing. We need to move everybody to the main lifeguard station. There's an ambulance there and more equipment and a stronger radio with an antenna. I hate to ask, but we can't do this without you. Will you help me?
I'll see what I can do.
Good. First off, we need an access card to get past the security gate. Mine's in my room. With all the commotion, I forgot to take it with. It's in Bungalow 11, by the pools. Take a weapon and watch yourself. You may be immune, but I don't mean you can't die.
No thanks to you.
This is the end of day. Judgment Day. It's in the Book of Revelations.
Fuck, I should have never listened.
Why the hell did I stay here with Cinnamoy? I should have listened to Maggie and left with James and the others. They probably found a way off the island by now. Maybe there's still time to find them. If you're out there and you see Maggie and the others, could you let me know where they are?
Sure.
Thanks. I'll be here. Because, I mean, you know, where the hell else am I gonna go?
Oh, my God.
Oh, God. Oh, God. I'm sorry. My wife. My dad. Oh, fuck. My own fucking brother. Jesus Christ. What else could I do? Let him kill me? Why are you looking at me like that? What the fuck do you want from me? I had no choice! Oh, God. Oh, God.
This is Roger Howard on a special assignment on the island of Banui. I'm investigating illegal logging and clear-cutting that's not only damaging the ecosystem here, but costing the people of Banui billions. I've been told that my life might be in danger as those behind this illegal activity will stop at nothing to protect their criminal enterprise. As a precaution, I will be leaving a trail of recordings wherever I go, so that if something were to happen to me, the truth would still be told. I'm leaving now to meet the informant with the lead of this investigation.
I do.
Beautiful. For a moment, you can almost forget.
Thank God you did it? All right. Thanks to you, we might all just make it.
No thanks to you.
We need to move. Okay, ready to go out there again? I need you to find a lifeguard station and see if it's safe. Can you do that for me?
Definitely.
Take the beach. It's the shortest way. We'll come as soon as we know it's safe. There should be a working radio inside. Signal us when it's clear, and we'll follow you.
Oh, fuck. Fuck. Oh, Jesus Christ. If you hadn't come along.
You want to come with me? I'm gathering any supplies I can find at the water sports rental kiosk. Maybe you'll find something that'll come in handy. There's a table inside you can use to repair your weapons. Look, take whatever you want. I have to get some rest. I'll rest up and then head out to meet my wife. I would have died out there without you.
Oh my God! Thank you.
are out. Ground control, do you read? We're making an emergency landing north of the city.
Bastard!
I knew you could do it. Hang tight, okay? We're coming right now. Everybody, pack up. We're on our way. Watch the road. We'll be there soon.
Nice job, mates. We're safe now, thanks to you. But we won't make it long without food. Help don't come soon. We're gonna have to head to town. Meantime, maybe you could see if anybody needs help.
We're safe here for now, but there's still a lot to do. A lot of people.
I heard this skirt. Out of space.
Can somebody help me with this bloody door?
Hey, remember me, mate. I'm the doctor, but I can't do much without medical supplies. The door to the infirmary is locked from the other side, and Anne's in critical condition. You think you can help me break the bloody thing down?
I'm in.
I appreciate it. Go on, then.
Good on you, mate. Now let me get to work. Cindy, what a bloody disaster. Nothing here at all, is there? We need to think of another way. Will you help me? I need you to locate an ambulance or one of the lifeguard vehicles. Inside, you'll find a paramedic bag with all the necessary equipment in it. I'm pretty sure I saw one by the Diamond Bungalows.
Let's do this.
Without your help, we'd all be 6 feet under by now. Or bloody walking corpses.
An alien infection is what it is.
This baby needs some new spark plugs or she ain't going nowhere. Shame, though. It's a hell of a car. A battalion of those freaks wouldn't slow this baby down. So, if you can find me a few necessary parts from any nearby wrecked cars, and we get this ride rolling, I'll let you take her out anytime you want. Deal?
Sure.
Excellent. You locate those parts. You know where to find me.
Thank you.
Whoa, great job. Nice. Now just give me a sec and I'll get this bitch running.
I heard the skirt. Came from outer space.
You just saved a lot of lives, mate. You may have even saved Anne's. Thank you.
Take a look.
Kelly's worried about her husband, Will, but I think he's probably okay. If you happen to be nearby there, can you see if you can find him?
I'll do my best.
His name is William. He's about 6'1", black hair, good looking. He's a concierge. He has a friend named Doyle who works in the Diamond District bungalows. I'm thinking maybe he's hiding out there.
Out in such a rush, I left my necklace behind at the hotel. It's in bungalow 6 in the silver section. My husband gave it to me. It means a lot to me. I'm offering a reward. Can you help me?
Yes.
Thank you. Please be careful.
I'm Dominic. This piece of shit antenna's too weak to reach past the island. We need a signal amplifier to cut through the static. I worked on an antenna at the lighthouse nearby. I'm sure they got an amplifier there. We wouldn't last a minute against those things, but you, think you can get it for us?
Yes.
All right, excellent. You bring it back as soon as you can.
Feeling like I'm back, these bodies are starting to rot. You smell that? We need to burn them before they start attracting more of these walking dead motherfuckers. Do me a favor. See if you can't get some gas from that station nearby.
Okay,
good. See if you can find a car. That way you can move more gas.
My husband. He's bleeding. Can you help us?
Name's Roger, brothers. And this is my wife, Jess. We were driving like a bat out of hell when I saw that broke down car. Part of me said, forget about it. But I couldn't do that and live with myself. So we stopped to see if we could help. The driver must have been in shock or something because he threw himself at us like a crazy guy. I had to kill him. But this was self-defense. I was protecting myself. You gotta believe me. But you know what? He took a bite out of me, man. Shit. I think I got whatever he had. Rabies. I don't know. Fuck. Who the hell knows? But can you get Jess out of here? If I start to lose it, I don't want to bloody hurt her.
I'll do my best.
Hey, man. Thanks. Should take her to the lighthouse. My brother James should be there. He'll take her in.
People living in the lighthouse?
Can't be. I can't believe you're alive. When we last saw you, like, Jesus. Anyway, you better go see the Giants.
Sure, be surprised as hell to see you. Thank you. Can you check on my husband?
Thank you.
It's running like a dream. This ride is yours whenever you need it.
Ah, man, Maggie was right.
Yes. This is it. Oh, thank you. Thank you so much. Here's the reward I promised. Thank you.
I heard this skirt.
Came from outer space.